Shepherd of a soul, Shepherd of a soul,
Savior of a soul, Lover of a soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We
only King of Kings, the only Lord of Lords, that who was, that who is, and that who is to come. We bless your name, we worship your name, we glorify your name. The one that grief could not hold bound, the one that hell could not withhold, the one that sin could not hold bound. We say glory and honor belongs to you, Lord Jesus Christ, in your name, in Jesus Christ's mighty name, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Father, our God, we thank you because you give us the privilege to know what is hidden from the prudent. We are little babies. We have come to eat and dine with you, to celebrate you in sober reflection, to remind ourselves of what you went through for us to redeem us. Lord, I made myself available again. Speak to me and speak to me to the end that we all will be blessed to come and dine with you in heaven on the last day. Lord, I expel every powers of the wicked, every mind-wandering spirit, butterfly spirit, I cast you out from my midst now, even as the Holy Spirit has taken over. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, I pray.
Amen.
But then just as that song said just now, you love us, we cannot explain. We have a message before us this hour titled, The Unmerited Adoption into God's Family. The Unmerited Adoption into God's Family. You being adopted into the family of God is totally unmerited. You becoming a child of God today is totally what you and I never merited. It's a gift from the Lord. It's by the grace of God that you and I are being selected to be adopted into the household of God. It's a grace, a gift from heaven through Christ to you and I. Brethren, you and I were predestined or predestinated into the adoption of the children of God by the mercy of God. We are made the children of God today. As I said the other day, you being created as a child of God was abolished. The grace of being created to enter God's kingdom was cut off. What we are now enjoying is the grace of adoption through salvation by redemption. So we are made the children of God today, not by merit, but by the mercy of God. not by merit, but by the mercy of God, we are being adopted to become the children of God. Hence, the Bible told us in Ephesians chapter number 1, from verse 3 to 7. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Verse 4. According as he has in him. Please, can we all listen? Thank you. Verse 4, I take it again. According as he had chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, meaning before this world was created, you were known. Your redemption was pre-planned by God even before you were created. That we should be holy. That we should be holy and without blame before him in love. Verse 5. Having predestinated us, having pre-know us, having pre-seen what he would do for you and I, unto the adoption, we are predestined to be counted among that will be adopted into the children of God. Not even just when you came to this world. Because he knows the end from the beginning. Having predestinated you and I into the adoption of children by Christ Jesus to himself, by the death and resurrection of Christ to himself. Hallelujah. According to the good pleasure of his will. It was the will of God that you and I must not perish. So he predestined us that when that my daughter is born into this world, I will adopt her to myself. That's why he sent Christ as a preparation ahead of you. So that when you are born, though you were living in sin, the power of his resurrection is salvation for your redemption. We pick it up in that prostitute house. If ever the Lord got hold of you. Verse 6. To the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he had made us accepted in the beloved. 7. In whom we have redemption through his resurrection by his salvation, by his gift of salvation. In whom we have redemption through his blood. I love this. The forgiveness of sin according to the riches of his grace. According to the riches of his grace, he adopted you to the blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary. Brethren, we were fully entangled, engrossed in bondage under the element of the power that ruled this world. You were picked by the power of this world and soaked into sin. By so doing, you became a slave to sin. And by so doing, you were in bondage under the power of the devil. But they're delivered and redeemed in the fullness of time through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. All was done by the mercy of God, by the love of the Father. By the mercy of God, through the love of the Father, and by the grace of him that redeemed us. Galatians chapter 4, 1 to 5. Galatians chapter 4, 1 to 5 or 1 to 6. Now I say that the heir, as long he is a child, different nothing from a servant, though he be Lord of all. Verse 2. But is under torture, tutors, and governors until the time appointed of the Father. Verse 3. Even so, we, you, I, when we were children, they're in the building under the element of the word. Verse 4. But when the fullness of the time was come, God sent forth his son, made of a woman under the law. 5. To redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. Verse 6. And because ye are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son in your heart, crying, Abba, Father. Before then, you had no father. I had no father. Before then, when you say father, you anger him. But in the fullness of time, the Lord God Almighty sent his son as a propitiation for our adoption, to buy us from Satan. And today, we are now the children of God. We cannot boldly say, Abba, Father. The Holy Spirit of God that make us to be children of God is now dwelling in us today. But before then, it wasn't so. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah. So
we must understand that it's not by works that we have done, or because of the family we were born into. Not because I was born into the family from Cesare that God rescued me, no. Not because my father was anything, no. But the mercy of God kept me out. Not because of the family we were born into, or because of the country we came from, that made us to be worthy of the adoption, to be adopted into God's holy family. But grace and mercy located your eye. Those who are born as Muslim, live as Muslim, die as Muslim, you are not better than them. Those who are born as Hindu, live as Hindu, die as Hindu, you are not better than them. But the Lord God Almighty predestined you that this one is fit for my kingdom. And we will not abuse that grace and that mercy in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It's written in Titus 3, verse 5. Not by works of righteousness, which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved you and I. Not by works, that's why I said, not by merit, but by mercy. Not by works of righteousness that you and I are saved, but according to his mercy, we are saved by the washing of regeneration and renewing of the Holy Ghost. By the washing of regeneration for recreation, for total reconciliation, we are saved by the Spirit of God Almighty. We were dead in sin and buried in the grave of iniquity. Yes. You and I were slain by sin, killed by sin, put in the casket of sin, buried in the grave of iniquity. Before grace and mercy located you and I in that grave and resurrected us to become who we are now in God. So therefore, we must no longer live as slaves again. We must no longer live as people who were slaves before any longer. But we must not also forget who we were when Christ picked us. We must no longer live as slaves anymore, but yet we must not forget where we were coming from, or where we came from, so that we don't overlead our adoption privilege. We have adoption privilege. We must not overlead it. That's why we must be conscious of sin. We must be conscious of this, so that it will not remind us that you were only adopted. When you get to, please read Romans chapter 11. You will see who you are and why you must humble yourself, because we're grafted in. If anything happened, you can be grafted that again. That's why we must respect, honor our adoption privilege. And don't overlift it. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 5 to 9. Even when we were dead in sins, he quickened us together with Christ. By grace, ye are saved. By grace, ye are saved. Not by your greatness. Not by the gravity of the work you have done. Not because of any other thing, but by grace and mercy we are saved. And has raised us together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. What an unmerited favor we have today. That's why whenever we come to enjoy him, we must do everything to humble ourselves. Because everything we are enjoying today is totally out of grace and mercy, not by merit or by qualification. Verse 7, that in the ages to come, he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness towards us through Jesus Christ. 8, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. Emmanuel, did you see that? Everything you are today, Emmanuel, is the gift of God. You are saved, it is gift. You are made an apostle, it's gift. You are on the narrow way, it's gift. It was not done by strength. That's why I said, by strength shall what? No man prevail. Be happy that you have such a gift from the Lord. By grace, you are saved. It's not by merit or by gift. Not of works. Verse 9. Lest any man should boast. Not because we have fasted that we have come to eating and drinking. No. Not because we come every time we fast, we break with it. No. It is what the Lord by mercy have given us. That's why every first Monday of the month, we also come to do without fasting. To tell you, it's not a ceremonial thing that we must, after fasting, come to eat it. No. It's a time that we reflect on who we were, who we are, and what brought us to where we are now, and where we are going, and what will take us there. It's by the flight of mercy and grace we'll be able to enter the kingdom of God. And the Lord will help us all in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It was the love of God that made us to become the children of God today. It was the love of the Father that prepared the Son to die a shameful death for you and I. As the Bible says, for God so loved the world, for God so loved you and I, that he gave his only begotten Son. That whosoever the Lord gives the opportunity to believe him. According to John chapter 6, verse 24, whosoever the Lord gives opportunity to believe him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. It was the love of God that made the Son to die a shameful death. 1 John 3, 1 and 2. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore, the world know us not, because it knew him not. Verse 2. Behold, beloved, now are we the sons of God. Hey, I love it. Now, just as the Bible told us in Romans chapter 8, verse 1. Now there is therefore no condemnation. Now, you were not before. Now are we the sons of God. Yesterday you were a daughter of Babel, daughter of the devil. John chapter 8, this is verse 44 or verse 42. You are of your father the devil. Why? Because you are not of God. Please, let me control that place for me, please. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, Now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know. Ah, thank you, Jesus. I don't know if you know, but I know that when he shall appear, I, Emmanuel, shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. First Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50 to 53. I shall be like him, from corruptible to incorruption. I shall be transformed. Know why? The grace and the mercy to do that has been poured upon me already, and nobody can do anything about it. So long I humble myself before him. And I pray we humble ourselves before him and do his will in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. John chapter 8, verse 44. Ye are of your father, the devil. Why? Because his will you will do. Why are you doing his will? Because he has gotten hold of you. Because you are not yet redeemed from him. But today, as many that are hearing the sound of his voice, the grace of redemption have come upon you. You are out of that cage of the devil. You are now redeemed by the blood of the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I was talking about this for a time. Brethren, whatever does not send us to hell, Christ took it away. I mercy. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24. Who his own self bear our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, being dead to sin, shall live unto righteousness, by whose stripes beaten we are healed. Not just healed from fever, from headache, we are healed from sin. We are healed from destruction. We are healed from condemnation. That sin you were committing is a disease, don't you know? Sin is a disease. So the Lord called you and I, we are healed from the disease of sin. And whenever man is healed from the disease of sin, every other sickness is also going away. As you eat him now and drink him, whatever sicknesses that sin has brought our way shall be flushed out instantly in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Okay. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
Take only the blood of Jesus Christ to do this. When you get to believe God's time, read Leviticus chapter 17, verse 11. Only his blood is capable of cleansing you and redeeming you. You also read Hebrews chapter 9, verse 12. Neither by the blood of goats or calf, but by his own blood, he entered into the holy place, having obtaining eternal redemption for you and I. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
The payment of our adoption was paid completely. Can somebody shout hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Paid it completely. For me and for you. And there's nothing the devil can do about it. 1 John, verse 1, stop here. And he is the propitiation for our sin. He is the payment of our sin. And not for us only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Though he did it for the whole world cannot just come, except those who he has selected. Except my father called them, they shall by no means come. And you are one of them. And I believe, through you, every member of your family shall also receive mercy to become the children of God from henceforth in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now that you have seen this, now that you have heard this, that you are not saved by merit, but by what? Mercy. Why don't you stand up or kneel down and say, Father, I thank you. I give you all the praise. Everything about me today is by mercy. I'm even breathing is by your mercy. Thank you. And I receive the grace, not to disgrace this grace you are giving me. I received the grace not to abuse this mercy, never to go back to my sin again. Open your mouth and pray if you are the one God has spoken to this afternoon.
Praise the Lord. This is a mountain of solution and redemption prayer ministry worldwide, aka the Shepherd and the Bishop of our Souls ministry worldwide.